Hey guys, NeoScyther here again, doing something I've not done in quite a long time. First, I apologize if I seem a little quiet. It's like almost 1 o'clock in the morning, and I just got the inkling to do this. I've not done a demo review for a while, so I figured I would go ahead and check out the demo for Castlevania Lords of Shadow 2 on Steam. Just to kind of start things off a little bit here, I don't really have a lot of experience with the original Lords of Shadow. I have literally played the demo, and that was it. And I did like what I played at the demo, I just never had a chance to pick up and play through the game itself yet. So, excuse me, I can't really compare the Lords of Shadow 2 demo to the original Lords of Shadow. I just don't know enough about the original to play through it. So, basically, I'll just be straight up talking about Lords of Shadow 2. So, yeah, you play as probably one of the more non-traditional, I guess you could say, looking Draculas I've ever seen, but yeah, I don't know the whole history behind the game, so yeah, I'll play the original Lords of Shadow eventually, I swear. So, you start off with Dracula in his throne room, drinking from a cup. I fully expected him to go into his Symphony of the Night speech. Or, I can't remember what game that originated from, to be honest. The whole, what is a man speech. So, yeah, again, 1 o'clock in the morning is messing with my Castlevania history. So, yeah, he's kind of sitting there, and you got guards trying to break down the door. And once they do, and the action actually starts, two things I've noticed that I really like as I pull the mic away from my mouth a little bit. The first is the game instantly picked up my controller. I didn't have to change any settings or map anything. It just recognizes it straight up. I like when games do that. The second thing is, as it gets going, it'll give you like little tutorial commands for everything. Like it'll tell you what buttons do normal attacks, sweeping attack, moving the camera, just moving around. Later on, you'll be able to pull out a sword that can drain life from your opponents and quite a bit of it. You can also pull out little gauntlets that can break shields. So you start off with very little life. I'd say maybe about looks like about maybe a third of your health bar, maybe. But you will change that quickly. The big thing you'll learn is holding down left trigger, or well, left trigger to block. And while you're holding down left trigger, you can use the whatever your movement controls you use are either a D-pad or a control stick to quickly dash away. And you see me use that a lot once I figure it out. If you keep failing a tutorial, or at least the couple that really matter, it'll just keep going to get it right. The one I keep failing is it wants you to hold down left trigger while you repeatedly hit X to like counterattack. And yeah, I didn't realize it wanted me to hold it down while hitting X. I thought I had to release it to hit X. Versus now press X repeatedly. Yeah, I felt that a few times. Something else I found really weird is that Dracula's using a whip. Again, I don't know if maybe it's part of the story where this is considered the vampire killer, or maybe it's not a whip and I'm just really out of touch with Lords of Shadow. I don't know. So I found that a little strange, but overall it's not too bad. It would have been nice if there was some sort of targeting in the system. So like maybe hold down. I don't think right bumper did anything. Maybe holding down right bumper to autofocus on an enemy would have been a little easier, especially when you get later on, you get multiple enemies with shields. You pull out the gauntlets like I mentioned, and you want to keep attacking the enemies with the shield, and I kept attacking enemies without a shield. Those weapons, the sword and the gauntlets, do drain, but the energy refills kind of quickly. And the sword will, I'm not going to say it deals massive damage, but it heals a good amount of life. Which you'll see the main use of that here in a few moments. So once you get past all the guards, you get introduced to climbing and jumping. You can hold down left trigger, and you'll be able to kind of light up the circle, or light up the little hand grip, so to speak, see where you can move to. That's pretty useful, especially later on. You'll see why. Once you get outside this, I don't know what you want to call an angel. I'm just gonna say some sort of golden angel, warrior, I don't know, drops down and decides to attack you. This is where I learned two things. One, holding down left trigger and constantly moving around, great for dodging this guy. I mean, a lot of his attacks come quickly. He has an undodgeable attack like the guards did back inside your castle. However, he will actually use two straight unguardable attacks. So definitely get used to holding down left trigger and moving around the dodge. The other thing I learned really quickly was I did mention that the sword takes, or doesn't really, maybe not takes away a lot of life, but it gives you a lot of extra life. I'm going to guess in the main game, maybe it's not going to take away as much, but I keep saying take away. Maybe it's not going to give you back as much, but it pretty much made the fight pretty much incredibly easy. After that, it was time to play Shadow of the Colossus. Oh, and I would be really remiss if I did not mention that before you fight the angel, Dracula gives pretty much the most well-known line in the Castlevania franchise. He does actually say, "What is a man but a miserable pile of secrets?" And during the fight with the Golden Warrior, the Golden Warrior will occasionally say, "Die, monster, you don't belong in this world." So, nice little nod to Symphony of the Night, and again, I can't recall what game that originally came from, if it did at all. Which I think it did. I want to say Rondo of Blood, or Dracula X, but don't quote me on those. So, then you get the fun of climbing up this giant robot. Literally. Pretty much this giant titan. It's literally like Shadows of the Colossus, and let me just say right now, I suck at that game. I think when I played Shadow of the Colossus last, I got to maybe the third Colossus. I think there's 8 in the game. I've seen a friend go through and completely just trash the game. Took a long time on the final Colossus, but it was amazing to watch him go through it. I can barely get past the second Colossus. So, yeah. Going up this thing reminded me of that, and my first thought was, am I going to survive this? The thing is, as you're climbing, the warrior is shooting these arrows at you, these explosive arrows. Plus, the gears can hurt you, send you back to like a little checkpoint. Beyond that, and I keep pulling stupid moves by just saying, oh, I can go right through the gear. No, I can't. So, yeah, some stupid maneuvers on my part. But once you get to certain points, you will have to have the angel shoot these locks on these like walls. And once all the locks are gone, you can get the wall out of the way, climb some more, and essentially go to the top and watch Dracula vomit blood. Okie dokie. Now don't get me wrong, I know it's Dracula, he's a vampire, he drinks blood. Heck, you can finish opponents off by drinking their blood and regaining a little bit of energy back. In fact, it's so little energy that I don't really think it's even worth it. But the CM vomit blood. Okay. And that's essentially the end of the demo. So overall, I mean, at first I thought the demo was going to end right before the Titan. I'm kind of surprised it didn't. But then when I had to go up to Titan, I'm like, oh my god, it's the Shadow of the Colossus all over again. But overall, I really enjoyed the demo for Lords of Shadow 2. I have a feeling the fight against the Golden Warrior won't be as easy, but that remains to be seen. Overall, I do want to go back and actually pick up the original Lords of Shadow, whether it's on 360 or on PC. I might just do it on PC. I got way too many games on Steam as it is, though. I got 160 games in my Steam library. This demo was 161. I have finished maybe five or six, like a couple in progress. But maybe someday I'll go back and get the original Lords of Shadow, finish it, and then once this one drops down in price when it gets released, I'll go ahead and pick it up. So I did enjoy my time with this. I hope you enjoyed my look at the demo for Castlevania Lords of Shadow, not Castlevania 2 Dracula's Quest. And I don't know when I'm going to get another demo up, whenever I feel like recording another one. So I thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.